broken heart and bitter cry, only you can take all my hurts away. Only you can restore that which is lost. Only you could pay such an incredible cost. Only you.
Hallelujah.
You have renewed.
He's done so much for us.
Amen.
What about you? Amen. 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 Anything for you?
Yes.
Amen. A few of you. Okay. Thank God. Maybe he'll give around to the rest of you. Hallelujah. God's been so good. He's been so good. You know, Sister Ginger was testifying about coming to the prayer meeting, I think it was last night, and how she's had peace in her situation. You know, I've been watching, I mean, it's not every night. You know, a lot of nights we're laboring. A lot of nights we're calling on God and seeking Him. A lot of nights we're praising Him and worshiping Him. A lot of nights we're just, you know, we're just dwelling in His presence.
Yes.
But then there are those nights that God starts doing something special.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. There was someone that told us that that wasn't doing too good, sick, I think, and was sitting around and said, "I wish it was 6 o'clock. So we can drive down to that prayer meeting and have them pray for me."
Hallelujah.
I mean, it was a shocker to me. I mean, God's doing some things. God, I mean, you know, I'm just saying, if you got somebody that's praying, that you know that's regular at praying, that's where you want to go to. That's the one you want to connect with.
Amen.
Because when it gets so bad that you don't know what to do,
yes.
You got to go to the one that can connect with God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, you say, well, everybody should be able to connect with God. But there's some people that they're right there with you. They've been praying. They've been seeking Him. I'm talking about diligently.
Jesus.
That's what it's going to take.
Jesus.
That's what it's going to take to move in people's lives. Hallelujah. Praise His holy name. God is so good. God is so good. Amen. What have we got, brother? A revelation of the fullness of God. A revelation of the fullness of God. You got to get a hold of that. Hallelujah. Because really, most everybody just knows God in part. I mean, you know, and some is just tiny parts. Some it's hair, small parts. But some know God. And they've had revelations of Him. Amen. And there's something about that type of person. There's something about that type of person that you want to be around if you're living right. Amen. Hallelujah. There's something about it, because you know they have a direct line. I'm talking about one that's always clear to God. How many in here, you've gotten down on your knees before and you felt like your prayers didn't even get to the ceiling? Just about everybody here, including myself, should raise their hand. Amen. But there's some people that just speak. They just speak to Him. Why? Because they've been talking to Him. They've been in His presence. And they don't allow Him to leave. Amen. Woo! Yeah. I'll tell you, I know we have jobs, we have families, we have all kind of things going on in our life. And it seems like when we're trying to get close to God, all of that turns into chaos.
Amen.
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 But God is a God that works in the middle of chaos.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
We allow chaos to distract us,
yes,
but God works in the middle,
yes,
of chaos.
Yes.
You're thinking, how is God gonna work in this mess? If you just keep seeking Him and keep your eyes on Him and keep your ears open to Him, the chaos will still be there, but you'll see God working in the midst. Amen? Working in the midst of it. And you'll think, God, there's so much chaos going on around us. It is just, it's so mind-boggling. It's so distracting. But He says, just focus on Me. I'm working in the midst of this chaos. Amen. And God is working right now in the midst of our chaos. Amen. He is working.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I
want to get into this, but I want to set the stage for it. Moses had been up on the mountain in the presence of God. He had been there, and in fact, he'd been there so long, and it was so strong that as he come down the mountain, he had to put a veil on his face because of the glory that shone from his face.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. You know what? I might need to get in His presence so I can just wear a veil. I mean, you know, nothing just to hide my ugliness. You know? I just need a veil. But he'd been up in God's presence and he come down. They had made a golden calf and was worshiping this thing. They were running around without clothes on. They were having all kind of things going on that we're not going to talk about. And Moses comes down in the midst of chaos. Amen? And it wasn't but right after that that he begins to talk to God. Then he begins to tell God, if You do not go with us wherever You're sending us, I don't want to go. Amen? Because I can't go if You do not go. Somebody needs to say that about their situations.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Come on.
You need to say, I'm not doing it if God's not going with me. I'm not getting into it if God's not in it. Amen? Hallelujah. So let's get into the reading here. Exodus 33. We're going to start with verse number 15. You have to excuse me. Sunday wrecked my voice, and Monday night and Tuesday night finished it off. But here we go. Thank you, brother. They won't fall and break my neck. Exodus 33, beginning with verse number 15, says, And he, being Moses, said unto him, being God, If thy presence go not with me, carry us not up hence. For wherein shall it be known here that I and thy people have found grace in thy sight? Is it not in that thou goest with us? So shall we be separated, I and thy people, from all the people that are upon the face of the earth. And the Lord said unto Moses, I will do this thing also that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace in my sight. Here it is. And I know thee by name. And he said, I beseech thee, Lord, show me your glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Show me your glory. And he said, I will make all my goodness pass before thee, And I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee, and will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and will show mercy on whom I will show mercy. And he says, thou cannot see my face, for there shall no man see me and live. And the Lord said, behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock, and it shall come to pass, while my glory passes by, that I will put you in a cleft of the rock, and will cover you with my hand while I pass by. And I will take away my hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shall not be seen. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you for your love, your mercy, your grace. Thank you, dear God, for everything you've done here. All that you're doing, all that you're going to do. God, I give you praise and glory for it all. I thank you, dear God, Lord, that you're here moving in our midst. I thank you, Lord, that your presence has not left us nor departed from us. But I thank you that your presence is growing stronger and stronger in the midst of us. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for the way you're moving. Thank you for the people you're touching. Thank you for those that you are saving, healing, and delivering, Lord. Thank you for hearing our prayers and hearing our cries. Thank you for answering. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. You may be seated. Well, I've got a question about Moses wanting to see God's glory. I mean, who in here has seen God or heard him speak out of a burning bush? Who in here has God called into his presence and said, take off your shoes, for the place you're at is holy ground? But he did for Moses. And also, whenever the 70 elders were together, Moses got a glimpse of God's glory. And also, when he went up to the mountaintop, he was in the presence of God. God was all around him. And also, when the tent of meetings, that the glory of God was like a cloud that came down so strong that the priests could not even minister. Man, he saw all kind of God. I haven't seen any of that. I felt it, but I haven't seen it. He saw it, he heard it, and he felt it. But yet he still asked God, show me your glory. He still wanted more of God after being that close to God, after being in his presence, after witnessing the power of God all around him. He still wanted more. He still wanted more. He still wanted a revelation of God. You know what's sad? What is sad is people that have been Christians their whole life. They've sought God. They've been in powerful meetings. And then one day, they just sit down. They don't seek him like they used to. They don't cry out to him like they used to. They don't worship him like they used to. And most of the time, the only time they really get serious with God is when things are falling apart. But used to, they didn't wait on trouble. They worshiped him in the good time. They praised him in the good time. They loved him in the good times. Amen. We need to get back to the place where we want to see his glory.
I'm not praying for a revival to break out here.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. I guess y'all are waiting on me to finish that. All right, let's have a board meeting. We're getting rid of the pastor. I'm not waiting. I'm not looking for a revival to break out. I'm looking for a revival to break out in you.
Come on.
Amen.
This little soul.
Hallelujah.
In you. That little circle. In that little circle. In that little circle. If we can ever break.
Come on.
If revival breaks out like what you think revival is, people are just going to, oh yes, bless it, Lord, and not do anything, not feel anything, no change, amen, nothing. And they're going to call people, oh, we got revival going on there. People's going to come in and see you sitting right there doing nothing. Amen. But what I want is revival to bring down in our hearts and in our lives. Because if it ever does. Woo. If it ever does, we won't have to wait for your favorite song. If it ever does, it doesn't matter what the preacher is preaching on. If it ever does, we won't have to have an altar call. Hallelujah. I wish I could preach. If it ever breaks out in us as individuals, you'll see something amazing. It's already happening. It's already touching people's lives that have not been to a single prayer meeting. You hear what I'm saying?
Come on.
It's touching people. I've been hearing about it. Touching people that haven't even come, that haven't even participated. It's touching them. There's a war going on.
Hallelujah.
In my life.
Jesus.
God's saying, you're doing exactly what I want you to do. And the enemy says, sooner or later, it's got to stop. And God's saying, you're doing exactly what I want you to do. And the enemy says, that sooner or later, it's got to stop. All right? And I'm like, somebody, we have prayer meeting next, oh yeah, Monday, Tuesday, Friday. Yeah. Amen. Well, I won't be able to make, that's okay. Well, I won't be here, that's okay. I may not be here at one of them. Amen. You may not be. But there's going to be somebody here that's going to pray. There's something going to be. I think we've been doing it, 10 weeks, somewhere around there. And I've watched people come in here and get breakthroughs.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
And I I'm not trying to embarrass. But Brother Tony come in here, and the devil told him that he was through. He would never receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost again. And it happened.
Yeah.
Speaking in tongues. Mine is not the same. Brother Chris has been going through a lot of stuff. I've been right there with him, trying to help him and encourage him. And he's been facing a lot. You just had to be here to see that. But he broke loose. He broke loose. I mean, I was just praising God. He was getting with it here.
Jesus.
And I looked at Brother John while we was close to the beginning of service, and I said, look at Brother Chris laugh.
Hallelujah.
I said, I hadn't seen him laugh like that
in a while.
Sister Ginger came and said there she has peace. Amen. God's been doing things in my life. There's been a war there, but God has just given me something. I can't explain what it is that's going on in my life that God's been doing. But something's happening in my life. Amen. Something is happening. And maybe one day I'll understand it, but I know God is doing something. And God is doing something in some other people's lives. And He's going to keep on doing it. We're going to keep on seeing people's lives transformed. Seeing people come out of their shell, come out of their box. Why? Because they want to see the glory of God. General overseer told those under him, the executive committee, that he had a vision and he saw hot spots all over the place where revival started breaking out. He told this a long time ago. He told it before people even thought about what was going to happen. Okay? And it probably went about a year or so, you know, it wasn't coming to pass. I saw him tell it at Tommy Bates' church. There was another place he told the same thing. And he was brave because there's people all over the world that listen to him. He was brave by professing what God had shown him. And God's doing it. So I've seen people get all kind of powerhouses to come to their church and preaching, and I'm thinking in my flesh, I wonder what we need to do. You know, is that what we need to do? And all of a sudden, it just like something in my spirit says, not. And I'm like, well, you know, people are having revival, you know. And I mean, I don't know if their lives are being changed or if a man's coming and preaching and they're shouting and things going on about the way doing the same thing that they've always done. I don't know. I don't know. So I'm thinking on this. Been thinking on it ever since they started breaking out. Started breaking out at the schools. Now all the churches are doing it, you know, getting it going, jumping in with this thing. And God's moving, and I'm thinking, what are we doing? And for a whole year or more, I knew we were supposed to start prayer meeting at some point. And my thoughts was, what night? I know y'all wish, what night? But God just kept moving on me. And then it got to a place to where we had finished most of our projects. And it's like God started compelling me to start it. And I didn't know what to do. not lying to you, I'm just opening up to you. I did not know what to do. And then he led me to do it on Monday and Tuesday and Friday night. And I thought to myself, well, that would be good for a couple weeks.
Come on,
Father. I mean, I'm just telling you, that would be good for a couple weeks. You know, and then it'll just be me and my wife. I'm just telling you the thoughts I had, okay? I'm just telling you the thoughts I had, because a lot of times the pastor's left with it. A lot of things, a lot of times. Well, one thing I'm thankful about here is y'all don't leave me with it. Oh, you go ahead and pat yourself on the back. I'm talking about you. You don't leave me with it. And we started it, and then that war started. And God let me know that I didn't have to have anybody to come in here. That we needed to get on our face before him.
Jesus.
And he would do it.
Yes.
In fact, when he does it, it will change lives.
Amen.
It will change lives.
Amen.
Has anybody in here, has your life been changed by these prayer meetings?
Yeah.
I know everybody's not going to raise their hand. It's doing it. It's doing it little by little. He's reaching out here. He's reaching out there. Amen. We're going to have revival in our life. And when enough of us get revival in our little circle, this church is going to be a revival. In fact, this church is going to be on fire. You haven't got to wait till the preacher gets up here to get some fire going. Because you're going to be on fire. You're going to be burning. You're going to be shouting. You're going to be worshiping. You're going to be praising. I know how it is when you're tired. You've been serving God for a long time. You've been going through so many battles. And you're tired. You get tired. You get battle worn. You have scars. People hurt you. People turn against you. People reject you. People talk you down. I know how it is. Some people say, well, I got hurt one time and I haven't been back to church. My God, I get hurt about a half a dozen or a dozen times every year. It's been happening almost 20 years. Okay. Trying to pastor and be hurt continuously. People walk away for crazy reasons. Amen. Ripping your heart out. Some people say, I'll never get close to anybody again. Let me tell you something. I'll give you my heart again. I'll give you my heart again. I cannot step back and not give people my heart. Amen. I don't care how hurt I get. I don't care how many times I get hurt. I'm going to still love you. I'm going to still put it all out there for you. Why? Because I want your life changed. Because I go to the one that can heal my heart. I go to the one that can put my pieces back together. And he'll stand me up. And he'll reach his arms up under my arms. And if I can't walk, he'll carry me. Amen. I've learned to let him carry me. I've had him carry me over and over and over again. He'll carry you the same way. He'll carry you. We got to shake it off. people in here, you're scared. I mean, really big time of spiders. Some people just scared of gnats. You know what I mean? Jesus. They just tear up the whole house trying to kill it. I used to coon hunt with some guys. In fact, I've done it by myself out there in the woods, turn my dogs loose, and they walk a half a mile into the woods to where they got the coon tree. And there's a certain time of the year that they start making their webs. And you've heard of those big banana spiders. And I talk about it's rough. It's so rough. It's a big, rough web. And I've been walking along looking for the snakes, and that thing wrap around my head. A ninja turtle. Yeah. Not no ninja, a ninja turtle. I just go berserk, and rest of the night, I'm doing like this, checking everything. Because I still haven't found that big old spider. Okay? Still haven't found it. So it freaks me out. Hallelujah. Some people are scared of lizards. Some are scared of snakes. I want to tell you something. You have to treat that hurt and that pain and that brokenness just like I did when that spider web got around me. Now, I'm not going to try to imitate what it looked like. Because back then I could move. Now, you know, I'm just getting, you know, just get parts of it together. Amen. It just had to bite me because it can't get there fast enough. But you need to be just like that. You need to start shaking that junk off. And you need to start crying out to God and say, Lord, show me your glory. Show me. I'm tired of sick. I'm tired of dying. I'm tired of withering away. Show me your glory. My goodness. Somebody. You say, well, I've been doing this so long that, you know, my journey's coming close to the end. You don't know. You may have 10, 20, 30 years left. Amen. This is what Paul said. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 6 through 8. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. Part of the time. Say that. He said, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have what? Finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. Amen. Have you fought to the end?
Help us, Lord.
That's the question. This is the mindset. Well, we got some younger ones here now. We got some new people in here. Let them pick up the torch and carry it. I'm just going to sit back and enjoy myself and relax and just worship, you know. You've stopped. You've given up. You've quit. We cannot do it. Once again, Lord, show me your glory. Once again, dear God, let me feel your anointing. Once again, Lord, let me rise for the occasion. Once again, Lord, let me pick up the torch and run till I finish my course. What does it say, brother? It's not over yet.
Amen.
Step into his presence and behold his glory. Hallelujah. Step into his presence and behold his glory. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. Somebody asked me, was a preacher was talking about his retirement. And I just listened. He said, you know, I'm going to try to retire at such and such age, I think 65 or something like that, 66. And he said, I'll have the insurance, I'm sticking money back. You know, I'll have that, have my Social Security. We're going to buy a house and live such and such place and go to such and such church. And he said, when are you going to retire? I said, when my toes stick up. And I'm laid back. And they're about to shut the box on me. I'll retire then. I'm not looking for it. I'm just getting started.
Amen.
I'm just getting started.
Hallelujah.
I'm just getting started.
Thank you.
There's too many people dying and going to hell. There's too many people that are being misguided by crazy beliefs in this day and time we're in. I've got a job to do. I've got a job to do. But while I'm doing it, I don't care how much chaos is going on around me, I want to be in his presence. What about you? What about you? Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. See, it's not time to quit. It's not time to quit. You need to be saying, Lord, show me your glory. You know, God could have made it a simple process. He could have said, okay, here it is. Whoop. Whoop. There it is. He kind of made it complicated. He said, listen, he said, you won't see my face. He said, well, I'll tell you what, there's a rock over here. Let me put you in that rock. And whenever I start to come by, I'll push you back in the cleft of it, hide you, and then when I walk by, I'll move my hand and you can see the back part, just a glimpse of it. So he made it a little complicated. He made it to where Moses had to do a little something. There was action in this scene. Amen. Does anybody hear that?
Yes.
Action.
Yes.
Action. Amen.
Yes.
Not recliner. Not couch. Not TV. Action. Amen.
Hallelujah.
We've got to put some action into it.
Hallelujah.
To get into his presence.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
What does James say about faith and works? Faith without works is dead. He's not talking about unto salvation. He's talking about because of salvation.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. In other words, I had faith to get saved, but because of my salvation, I've got works to go along with that faith. If you ever stop working, your faith will die.
Amen.
I'm not talking about on your job. I'm talking about your relationship with him. If you ever stop working, your faith will die. That's Bible. That's Bible. We got to start praying. We got to start seeking God. We got to start studying his word. We got to start witnessing. We've got to start reaching out to people. Amen? This is not a clan. This is not a clan. Because he said, whosoever will, let him come unto me. Whosoever. Amen? We've got to reach out to whosoever. Because if we stop working, our faith will die. Father, thank you. Thank you, Lord. God, that you're here for us. Thank you, dear God, that you're here to help us. Thank you, dear God, that you're ministering to us. Thank you, dear God, that you have spoken to us. Thank you, dear God, that you've spoken to wake us up spiritually. Thank you, dear God, that you're moving in our midst. Thank you, dear God, that you've opened the truth to us. Thank you, Jesus, for moving. Thank you for stirring. Thank you for helping us. Thank you for giving us strength here. Thank you for it, Lord. Thank you for it, Jesus. God, we hear what you're saying. We hear what you're saying, Lord. We hear what you're saying, Lord. We're listening. We're hearing what you're saying. But will we be obedient to it? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Dear God, help us. God, I thank you. I thank you, dear God, that, Lord, I see these people working. I see them diligent about what they're doing. And they're doing this in the midst of chaos, Lord. I thank you for them. God, I thank you how they haven't left us to do everything. That they've been good about jumping in and helping out and doing this and doing that. I thank you, Lord, that they've been coming to prayer meeting, Lord, seeking you, crying out to you. I thank you, Lord, that they've been in their homes seeking you, crying out to you. I thank you that they've been studying your word. And Lord, I just praise you for it. I praise you for it. Dear God, we've got to get to the place to where we say, Lord, show me your glory. Show me your glory, Lord. Show me your glory, dear God. Show me your glory, Lord. Oh, God. Dear God. Dear God, help us. Help us this evening. Hallelujah. Does somebody just lift their hands and say, Lord, God, just show me your glory. Show me your glory, Lord. God, help me to seek you like I should. Help me to cry out to you like I should. But God, also help me to labor for the kingdom like I should. God, I believe in you right now. I believe in you right now, Lord, that you're going to help us. I believe in you right now, dear God, that you're going to make a way where there seems to be no way. I believe in you right now, Lord, that you're going to start opening up doors. I believe in you right now, Lord, that people are about to have revival in their life, Lord. I believe in it, Lord, and I believe it is going to touch other people. My goodness. God, we need you here. We need you, dear Lord. We need you, Lord. We praise your holy name. We praise your holy name, Lord. We praise your holy name, dear God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for doing the work. Thank you for doing the work. I want to say something. I want everybody to listen to this. When it's raining outside, especially you ladies, I don't know, some of you men don't want your hair wet. Hallelujah. What about that, brother? No, really. You know, what do you start looking for?
An umbrella.
An umbrella?
something to cover that and stop the rain. And some of you, it's, I mean, I have to have, we've got probably a half a dozen umbrellas. We probably got two in each bed. Because that woman's hair is not going to get wet. Amen? It's not going to get wet. I mean, if I have to take my jacket off and hold over it, you know, I mean, whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Look at chaos as if it's the rain. Do you hear me? What is the rain? Okay, I'm going to say it again. Maybe y'all get it this time. Look at the rain as if it's chaos. Now, what's the rain?
Chaos.
Woo! Boy, that took twice. And then look at the umbrella as if it's God. Do you understand what I'm saying here? So you're looking desperately for that umbrella. Poof. To keep you out of the rain. If you will look for God in the midst of your chaos, you hear me? It may keep raining chaos, but you've got God covering you. You hear me? You've got God covering you.
Hallelujah.
Because I've been here for a while. There's been a lot of chaos, but for some reason, I see God doing things. I see God moving. I see God changing things. And the chaos is not as bad while I'm watching Him work. Keep your focus on Him, even in the chaos. Even in the chaos. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, some preachers say, if you'll give me 5 more minutes, but I'm fixing this and this. Because they never take 5, they always take 10 or so. The reason I try not to say that, because I know I'd be lying.